We all have come across or might have even used the Snapchat filters, which can overlay funny graphics on your face. Also, Apple has recently introduced a so-called Animoji, which mimics your expression into a 3D animated character that looks pretty realistic. Hakuna Matata, what a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. All of these are interesting to play with, but you might have wondered how this stuff actually works. So basically, it's a type of machine learning model called convolutional neural networks. When given enough labeled image data to train on, learns the facial features like eyes, nose, mouth, and then returns a portion of key points. This technology is a valuable tool in areas like biometric facial recognition, expression analysis, and also in medical diagnosis. We'll be exploring this today and building a model from scratch to detect the facial key points in real time. And by the end of this video, we'll be able to build something like this. So stay focused. So first we need some data to train our model. Our dataset should contain images of human faces and its labels containing the XY coordinates of the facial key points. Well, after looking on the web for some freely available dataset, I found a dataset from Kaggle which seems to contain around 7000 training images with 15 facial key points. But after downloading and examining the data with a simple Python script, I observed that only 2000 images had 15 key points while rest of them had just 4. So what we could do now is scrap all the image data with 4 key points and just keep the ones with 15. And now we are left with the training set of 2140 images, which might be a bit low, but we could work with it for now. We'll be coding the model with Python using Keras library. So here we have a convolutional architecture containing 5 major layers, 1 fully connected layer and a target output layer. Each of the major layers contain a convolutional layer and a pooling layer of size 2x2. Now the first convolutional layer contains 16 filters, the second one has 32 filters, the third has 64, the fourth has 128 and fifth has 256 filters. All of these filters are of size 3x3 and we'll be using ReLU activation function in these layers. Well, after that, the flattened values from the 5th major layer will be fed to the fully connected layer with 512 nodes. And then the values will be finally sent to the output layer with 30 nodes. And that's our network architecture. And in case you're wondering why I choose these specific layer settings, it's a trial and error process. Testing the dataset with different settings and choosing the one which gives the least loss and which fits the data well. Now the model architecture is ready, let's train our model. Here we'll set the number of epochs to 60, batch size to 64 and use Adam optimizer with the mean squared error loss function. It might take from 3 to 15 minutes depending upon CPU or GPU you're using. So as the model was training, we saw that the accuracy had gradually moved up from about 50% to an accuracy of 84%, which seems reasonable. I tried modifying the network by adding few extra layers and also tuning some hyperparameters, but about 84 was the highest I could achieve. I'm sure by using a bit more data to train our model might yield a higher accuracy, but for now this looks pretty good. So if we plot the loss graph of the training, it looks like there's a steep curve in the beginning and then both the training and validation loss flattens down and pretty much converges. This confirms that our model did not overfit the training data but actually understood the facial features well. So now that we got our model fully trained and ready, we can test it with some random images from the web. But before that, we need to make sure only the grayscale images of dimension 96x96 is sent to the model, not the whole image which might have many faces at different locations. To achieve that, we need a face detector system which could give us the location of the face in the image. For that, we could either build a separate neural network model or use hair cascade face detection algorithm, which is lightweight and pretty robust to handle in our case. So after writing a few lines of code in OpenCV, I was able to get it working to give the location coordinates of the face. Then we could just crop that part of image to get the faces. Now the straightforward task is to feed each of these face images into our trained model to get the detected facial key points. To make it work on a video or in a real-time video feed from a webcam, we can use OpenCV to read the video file, then we'll run it through a while loop where each frame of the video is sent to our model, which will then return the coordinates of the detected facial key points. So here are some of the images that I have tested with, also some video clips. And that's it for this video. If you want to download the code for this project, I have linked it below in the description. You can download it, it's a Jupyter Notebook file. Also, please make sure to like the video and subscribe since I'll be uploading more contents related to machine learning and AI, so stay tuned. Also, if you have any doubts or suggestions, leave them below in the comments. And that's all for now. See you next time.